Welcome back to Brain Muffin at the Movies, everybody. Hello, and I thank you for joining in. This is part of the Brie Larson video challenge. Six times Brie Larson was a real super life. It was a real life superhero. Man, it'd really help if I read was there 29, almost 30. She gained respect to fans with only her acting, but also her generosity, good deeds. Okay. Sure, I saw the handful of girls that went to see her movie. So real life superhero. She's I made a Girls' Day. Okay, all right, cool. Women in film, which is only decades old. She promotes female empowerment and equality. Okay, that if you want to look at it that way. So the Crystal and Lucy Awards, Larson was honored with the Crystal Award for her excellence in film. During appearance, she talked about USC's Hindenburg School of Communication and Journalism study that found that women and people of color were not well represented in the film critic and reviewer scene. Okay, maybe they don't want to be film critics. You know, anybody with a camera can start a YouTube channel and being a film critic all they want. And some of these people actually get invited to premieres when they get a decent following. So if they can, if they have the skills and they have the time to put in, they can anybody. And I mean, anybody, you can be a green monster with an eye in your middle of your forehead and build a channel for, to be filmed. No one is saying, well, because you're black or you're whatever, or you're a woman, you can't be a film critic. Okay. And if you want to say, well, what about newspapers? Those are all dying. Okay, the newspapers are dying. The traditional media is dying. Get on the new media and do whatever you want. Okay, that's just stupid. She gives back. Yeah, this really isn't. This is just contractor negotiation. This is so dumb because this is in their contracts. I do believe that Robert seems to be the only one who really, really, really enjoys this. He has, I believe, the most to be thankful for. The MCU resurrected his career. Iron Man resurrected his career. You know, and has made him a new person. I think you're going to find him the most gracious. I think Chris Evans is the nice guy. And Paul Rudd is a nice guy. Scarlett seems to be pretty good too, but, this is mostly contractual stuff. So nah, you're not going to get props from me on that. She's afraid to take a stand. Extras an advocate for sexual assault, survivors. Yeah. You know, for portrayal and rate, she was also an Oscar, Casey Affleck, who was once sued for alleged sexual harassment. She appeared reluctant about handling the statue and did not clap for him. Well, see, this was alleged, all right? So if he went to jail for, you know, if he definitely did it and got off because he's Casey Affleck, which I can't imagine he's Casey Affleck. I can't imagine that actually happening, that he could walk away from. That's one thing. Settle out of court. But you know, the Me Too movement got ridiculous, and there were women who said, well, I had sex with somebody 5 years ago and now I regret it and I'm gonna call it rape, and that diminishes from the real victims. Okay, so yeah, she raises awareness of what to stand up to. Okay, this is more really, this is just stupid. She's got a physical superheroes. Is this her now? Scarlet looks better than that. She does look better than Gal Gadot. I will say that Gal Gadot still looks like a skinny twig. So that makes her, oh, this is really, really sad. This is it's E Online. What am I expecting from E News? Can we load the comments without it going to a page in my screen capture? No comments. Oh, that's awesome. And there's my Facebook, thing. It's using Facebook for comments. So Karina Heller, I don't know how many people you've even looked at that. I bet you I'm going to get more people watching my video covering your, that would be funny. Here's what I would say is, so this contract negotiation, this is, I think, where she talked about. So women in film, listen, ladies, you know, and it really irritates me that I've seen Gates McFadden talking about this. She directed several episodes of the Next Generation of Star Trek back in, you know, the late 80s, early 90s, you know, Jonathan Frakes he's the one that paved that trail. He went through to Paramount University, and that's what the other actors on the show called it. He went to all of the meetings and you know, dealt with set design and talked to the producers before he directed a single episode. And he paved the way for LeVar Burton and for Gates McFadden. And I thought Patrick Stewart did a few of those. I can't remember if Marina Sirtis directed a few. But And they kind of wrote his coattails. And now Gates is all, well, there's no opportunities for women. Bull crap. There are opportunities for women all over the place. Here's a big thing. Penny Marshall. Go tell Penny Marshall that there are no places for women in film as directors. Or she dead? I can't remember. If she died, then I'm being a, you know, but she directed several movies. One of the best Tom Hanks comedies of all time was Big, directed by Penny Marshall, a woman. And that was how many years ago? 30 years ago. Contract negotiation, overreaction to something that isn't her. Now, if Casey had a whole series of women accuse him of sexual assault and was able to get away with it, then I understand. But this is a single incident. That's just marketing. She probably just used a standard image, and she doesn't have a superhero's physique. I'm sorry. Scarlett Johansson looks better. And so does several other women, but I mean, she's not bad. Like I said, she's not as skinny as Gal Gadot, but, the arms need work. So, and anyway, and that's not accomplishment. Okay. Go look at, you want to see a female superhero physique. Now, granted, she was a bodybuilder. And I'm going to blank on her name. Rachel McLish. Go look at her after she retired from bodybuilding and got rid of some of that overly, you know, muscle with, you know, male, growth and hormones and stuff like that. And look at her tough physique, especially when she was in her 50s. That is a female superhero physique. And Brie's not even close. I would believe Rachel in as Captain Marvel in her 50s with her broken back than I would believe Brie Larson. So anyway, that I might be a bit persnickety here, but this just seems like a way for Corrine Heller to get her name out there and get Brie Larson in the news. But hey, I mean, this is Brie Larson news, and you know, this does pertain to the superhero that she portrays on the screen, and we'll see if the Captain Marvel train can continue into Phase 4. Thank you so much for stopping by. Thanks for clicking like. Thanks everybody who has subscribed. I appreciate the support, and I look forward to hearing back from you. Good day. All right, I'm turning this other thing off. I don't care. I got one more after this. Okay, fine. All right, 3, 2, 1.